Good wishes, dear students. Now in this class we will study for class 10th economics students. We will study lesson 14, that is consumer awareness. In today's world where we all are consumers, we have to be aware of the things which we are purchasing, and this is our right also. And this becomes the duty for the producers to make us aware about the things or the goods and services which they are rendering for us. So in this consumer awareness, we will study what are the rights of the consumers and Consumer Protection Act. First of all, we are all consumers when we pay a price for a commodity or service and use it, we become consumers. So what should we do in such cases when poor quality of goods or changes more of commodity or services are being done? In this chapter we will study about how consumers are exploited and what the government is doing to protect their interests. Meaning of consumer. First of all, consumer consciousness towards his or her right and duties is known as consumer awareness. The knowledge of the consumers towards their rights and protection is called consumer awareness. So awareness is also very important, that we should know what are our rights. If we are exploited, if consumers are exploited, where they have to go for the grievances. Now, formats of consumers exploitation. When we as consumers do have sufficient information about the products, we usually get exploited and are sometimes even harassed by the business community. Like, we have a variety of goods available in the market, our demand for goods and services is influenced by the advertisements in televisions, newspapers and magazines. But just merely by watching the advertisement, it is not the correct thing that we should go and purchase that product. We should understand, we should be aware of the goods and services that we will consume. Some common ways by which consumers are exploited by manufacturers and traders are mentioned below. First is underweight and under measurement. These producers or sellers of goods do this type of things. They underweight the goods, but they take the money of the quantity which they have not given to us. The goods being sold in the market are sometimes not measured or weighted correctly. Substandard qualities are being sent to the market, selling of medicines beyond their expiry dates, and supply of defective home appliances are generally the regular grievances of consumers. Duplicate articles. In the name of genuine part or goods, fake or duplicate items are being sold to the consumers. High prices. Very often the traders change the price higher than the prescribed retail price. They sell more than the MRP, that is minimum retail price. They are selling more than that. That should also not be done. Lack of safety devices. In order to increase the sale of their product, some producers, especially of electrical goods, electronic devices and such other appliances, try to produce things of poor quality without caring for the standard or safeguard norms. Such things prove very dangerous for the customers, and some are even involved in serious accidents also. So those goods which could be very harmful, safety measures should be there, and this becomes a duty of producers to locate the safety devices on it. Artificial scarcity. In order to get more and more profit, certain unscrupulous traders resort to hoarding of things, that is doing black marketing, thereby creating artificial scarcity. Although scarcity of goods is not there, but they are holding it just to create more demand, and then they sell this product at higher prices. This is known as black marketing. So they sell these things later on at higher prices. Poor after sale service. While selling the things, salesman becomes very good to you. They sell the things anyhow. but after that when problem arises they will not listen. So after sales service is also very important. The high cost durable items such as electrical or electronic equipments, home appliances and car etc. need adequate after sales service. Durable items means those goods which will not perish quickly, like cars, televisions. They will be retained with customers for a long time. So after sales service is very important. The supplier does not provide the satisfactory after sales services despite the necessary payments. Adulteration and impurity is there in costly consumer items such as oil, ghee and spices. Adulteration is made in order to earn high profit. They mixed certain things which should not be mixed with these edible items. This is known as adulteration. In Hindi we say it milawat. So the supplier does not provide the this cause heavy monetary loss to the consumers as well as the spoil their health also. So many diseases are occurring nowadays. So many heart patients are becoming. This are due to the poor quality of food that we eat. Now, rude behavior and undue conditions in matters like LPG gas connection, fixing of a new telephone line, procurement of licensing items, etc. Consumers are often harassed and undue conditions are put before them. For these goods, we have to take license or we have to take the connections. We stand online in line and there are a lot of paper formalities and sometimes consumers are being harassed by the clerks and by the office person. So that should not be done. Now, reasons for consumers exploitation. Why consumers are being exploited? First is lack of information. In a free market economy, producers and sellers are free to produce any goods and services in any quantity and there is no regulation on the prices. In such cases, providing full and correct information about the product to consumer is of great importance. In absence of information about different aspects of the product, namely price, quality, composition, conditions of use, terms of purchase, etc., the consumers are liable to make wrong decisions and hence lose money. But in our economy, where it is a mixed economy, full capitalist economy is not prevailing. Hence, government intervention is also there through FDI and so many other agencies are there which keep a proper eye on this, and this ensures that on every product, quality, composition, expiry dates, MRP, that is maximum retail price, everything should be mentioned on the pack so that consumer would get information from these things. When there is lack of information, consumers get exploited. Shortage of goods and services. The consumers are exploited when the goods and services are not available in the required quantity or numbers. Limited supplies are a result, usually of lower production of goods as compared to the demand. This gives rise to tendency of hoarding and price increase. When adequate supply will not be there, this will increase the demand and at higher prices producers will sell their goods, which will lead to hoarding and black marketing also. Limited competition. In some cases, single producer or group of producers control the production and supply of a product. He is in a position to restrict the availability of supplies. There is thus a possibility of manipulation in prices and availability. When there is single producer or very few producers are there, they will do monopoly for their products. They will increase the price because there are no competitors of that product. So this is due to for these reasons consumers are getting exploited. Illiteracy is one of the major reasons to lead for the exploitation of consumers. The level of consumer consciousness in our country is generally low. The level of literacy directly affects the level of awareness about products and the markets. Ill effects of advertisements. So illiteracy, when people are mostly illiterate, in our country also, Due to illiteracy, they are unable to read properly the composition, the expiry dates which are given on the pack, and that's why they have become unaware of this product and get exploited. Ill effect of advertisement. Advertisements are being shown on TV and newspapers and magazines, so they put pressure and they create a desire to purchase those things, so they buy with a lightning speed and often repeat afterwards. Now, growth of consumer awareness. In India, the concept of consumer protection is not new. References to the protection of consumer interest against exploitation by trade and industry, underweight and measurement, adulteration and punishment for these offences were made by Kautilya, who was an Arthashastra economist. However, organized a systematic movement to safeguard the interest of consumer in a recent phenomena. This developed in the late 1980s and early 1990s with the growing liberalization of economy. Liberalization means where market was growing, where globalization was occurring, where people from one country could purchase product from other countries also due to globalization and liberalization. Liberalization means freedom for selling. So this has increased, but at the same time consumer awareness has also increased. When the government withdrew itself from the production activities and permitted the private sector to take over, it was realized that there is a greater need to enforce discipline and regulation in the market. The consumers have to be aware not only of the commercial aspects of sale and purchase of goods, but also of the health and security aspects also. Contaminated or adulterated food is a major source of human illness and suffering and results in serious loss of nutrition. Ensuring the safety of food is thus an important aspect of creating awareness and promoting consumer welfare. This called for a strong legal measure to ensure that the producers and sellers observe uniformity and transparency in prices, stocks and quality of their goods. The government also felt that promoting consumer awareness about the possible malpractices, that is ill practices being practiced by the producers, and providing the consumers the tools to control them is the only effective way to protect the right of the consumers. As a result, the government passed the Consumer Protection Act in 1986. As a result of this act, any businessman resorting to unfair means to be taken to task by the different courts set up at the district, state and national levels. As a result, the consumer began to be compensated for the loss they incurred by buying defective goods or in getting poor services. So this is consumer awareness, that if consumer gets exploited, they can file a case in the consumer forum, which is at the state level, district level and national level, and they will get compensation also, and the particular company will be punished if they will do the malpractice. So here box 14.1 shows the consumer movement, a global history. Though the consumer movement made its appearance in England after the Second World War, its real beginning was in 1962 when a declaration about the consumer right was made in America. At that time, four basic consumer rights was right to choose, right to information, right to safety and right to be heard were recognized by Ralph Nader, a consumer activist, is considered as the father of consumer movement. So Ralph Nader was proved as a father of consumer movement. March 15 is now celebrated as the World Consumer Right Day. In 1985, certain guidelines to achieve the objective of maintaining protection for consumers and to establish high-level ethical conduct for those engaged in production and distribution of goods and services were adopted by the United Nations. So UNO, United Nations Organization, has also done this thing for the consumer awareness and for the consumer right to be protected. Okay. So consumer behavior in the market we will study in next part. Okay, students, thank you so much for this part.